Hi, my name is Natarian Gurin, and I am with So Much Tenderness.
Hi, I'm Isaiah Letnin. I'm the lead of I Like Movies.
Well, it's very exciting. I am very grateful to be part of this program. I moved to Canada to pursue acting. I started working at OMB Canteen, just to dreaming one day to be here, and now I'm in the other side, making my dreams come true. So I'm very excited.
You know, it's really interesting. I've never been to a film festival before. I've never attended as a guest or like just an attendee. So it's really exhilarating. And then like it gets even more intense being a TIFF Rising Star. Like it's totally interesting, man. It's totally far out of this world.
I'm with So Much Tenderness. It's directed by Lina Rodriguez. It is a film about immigration, about South American Latinas moving to Canada and making a new life in here. However, the past come back and we have to deal with all of that. It's an amazing film, more inclusion, more diversity in screen, Latinas on screen, which is really good to represent Latinos. It is really important for me to represent Latinos. I love to have different stereotypes. Latinos have a story to tell, and I really want to break those stereotypes of Latinos.
It's the story of Lawrence Queller, a 17-year-old film enthusiast from the suburbs of Ontario. And it's kind of a coming-of-age, growing-up story about Lawrence realizing he's kind of a pretentious asshole and growing past being, like, a jaded film nerd who pushes other people out of his life because, you know, he's afraid of the relationships to have with them, you know?
And obviously, so many of the most beloved and iconic films are coming-of-age stories. Can you talk about what's maybe unique about this specific one?
No, totally. So I would say my adolescent experience was totally in line with Lawrence's, and kind of seeing that experience on screen is something I never saw growing up. Like, I rarely saw the, like, I'm putting up walls because I don't want to be friends with those people anyways because they don't know Radiohead. They don't, you know, like... So it was, it was really interesting. Super unique experience to kind of, like, bring that to life on the screen. And I think it's going to really speak to that super specific niche of kind of guy or girl. You know what I mean?
Did the process of making that make you rethink your own childhood, your own awkward phases?
Oh, totally, totally. I really had to, like, kind of tear those wounds back open, like, start digging at those again to kind of get into the space of being, like, a really emotionally volatile 17-year-old, you know? Bringing it back. Kicking it old.
Honestly, I'm just living the moment. I'm very excited to meet people, network, be with my fellow rising stars. And yeah, just enjoy, and hopefully this will be a next step in my career.
You know what? No, it's actually been very slow and chill for me since we wrapped I Like Movies, but I've just been hanging out. I make music under the name Hermit, and I have an album that I'm going to release, like, I don't know, maybe in the winter or something. I'll take my time with it, you know?
What kind of music is that? What would you expect?
It's kind of like SoundCloud rap stuff, like melodic hip-hop, kind of like maybe in the vein of like Kid Cudi or Young Lean or something like that. Yeah, yeah.
Sold. I want a copy. And guys, I guess, I mean, we're obviously here at TIFF, one of the world's premier film festivals. Can you talk about why, particularly after the last few years we've all lived through, events like this seem to matter now more than ever?
It feels so nice to just see people and just be in, like, it's so exhilarating and exciting to be in the presence of a crowd. It just makes me feel like a million bucks, you know? And like, I also live on the other side. I'm a huge fan of the media I consume. So it's very exhilarating to be able to participate in it in like in real life, like physical medium like this. I'm gonna go see Paul Dano with my eyes tomorrow, I promise you. That's so exciting.
Yeah, I'm very excited to be part of this, of being with people, being able to travel, being able to see the art, see people. And yeah, I just feel this warmth, you know, like, and this summer, it's, everything's really good. Yeah, I'm very happy to be in person here.
Hi, my name is Joshua Ojik. I am from Kitigan-Zibi. I'm indigenous from the Canada, Cree, and Anishinaabe. So I'm here, one of the indigenous rising stars. What's that called? I'm here for Bones of Crow. Honestly, I never thought of myself doing that or indigenous people by becoming up into this platform, being a rising star, and it just feels like I'm living the dream in some respects. Like, I don't know, it feels good. I like it. Definitely when I was growing up, I definitely wanted to see people like in these positions, and I wanted to see myself on screen or see other people like who looks like me. I'm like, damn, I can be whatever I want to be, you know? This is a design by Kai. Kai is a very good friend of mine, helped me out last minute, and I really love this, and I feel like I might take it. Yeah, Kai definitely down there helped me out, and it's great. I love it. I really wish I would have known the story behind it, but I just really like it. It looks pretty, and I thought it would be good on me, so. Love it with all you have. Be careful to the people who ask for help. When you keep on helping them, they're not helping themselves. Love those people, but also have some integrity.
My name is Carmen Madonia, and I'm starring in Luis de Filippis's debut feature, Something You Said Last Night.
It is beautiful to have you on the carpet here at TIFF. What does it mean for you, not just to be part of the festival, but officially designated a rising star?
It's such an honor. When I met Luis, I had no idea how much she would change my life with this role. I'm just really honored that she saw something in me and that she showed it to the world, and now I guess everyone else is going to see it. It's such a privilege. I'm really proud of her. Our movie is about a trans woman and her family on vacation. And it's really about how everyone in the family is having trouble seeing each other for who they really are. I was really proud to be a part of this movie because for me, it's one of the first trans roles I've ever seen where none of the conflict is around her being trans, whether that's her internal conflict or the conflict with those around her. And that was really powerful and inspiring for me. I'm really honored to get to play that role and to be a part of this story that I think is pretty groundbreaking. We can show so many different stories through a trans lens without focusing on the few aspects of being trans that so many people are already aware of. I think it's really beautiful that we got to tell a story about a conservative Italian family who's fully accepting of their trans daughter. I think that's a narrative that we don't get to see that often. And I hope we get to see more narratives like that, positive stories about trans people existing within our world that we can all relate to, not just for trans people.
You're very grateful to your director for giving you that opportunity. Can you talk about the relationship you had working on set?
Yeah. We met 2 years before we ever got to set, so we were very close by the time we got there, and it was very seamless. I'm lucky that she gave me a lot of trust and a lot of space and a lot of time to prepare as well. I'm really thankful to her for just giving me so many resources that once we got to set, it was really smooth sailing, honestly. We shot 19 days. It was a really, really fast time, but it was the best time of my life.
Do you think that people with different identities, different life journeys and experiences, taking ownership of storytelling is an important step?
Absolutely. The only reason I'm here today as a rising star is because a trans woman wrote this story, a trans woman directed this story. So many of the people on set were trans people who understand this story. When we have people telling their own stories, they're just more authentic. They resonate with everyone, and then you get to be at TIFF. So I hope that we can keep telling these stories authentically while also building more and more opportunities for young trans people to thrive in this industry.
I think in terms of authenticity, I know it's a sensitive question, but in recent years there's been a lot of dialogue about trans films where non-trans actors, stars of one kind or another, are attached to projects. Do you think that that is an issue? Obviously, I'm thinking Scarlett Johansson, you know, was briefly attached to play a trans character and then withdrew from the role because she felt it was inappropriate for her to take that role without a lived experience. I'm curious if you have a feeling about that, whether or not it is or isn't appropriate for non-trans actors to play those roles.
The reality is, acting always involves telling a story that you might not have experience about. I think it's, I don't really think it's about that. I think there's lots of great actors who could tell trans stories whether they're trans or not. Unfortunately, there are not many opportunities for trans people who look like me. And when we keep giving those opportunities away to people who there are lots of opportunities for, it just doesn't make sense. I think a big part of the reason why I'm here today as a rising star is because I understood this story in a way that I could tell it and have it resonate with an audience who isn't trans. And I don't know if a cis person would be able to do that in the same way that we accomplished in this film.
Can you talk about for you what the unique power of cinema is?
Yeah, I mean, working on this movie changed my life. But just seeing Louise's short that this movie is kind of inspired by, that alone really changed my life. It showed me an Italian family accepting their trans daughter unequivocally. And it was such a beautiful story. It showed me what was possible, and it got me here today. I'm really, really, really proud to be a part of this film. I think it's a really big moment for the trans community in film.
Is there anything else on the horizon for you apart from looking fabulous and enjoying yourself here at TIFF?
Yeah, after TIFF, I'm going to be going to San Sebastian International Film Festival for our international premiere.
Best of luck with that and enjoy yourself tonight.